So greetings of the day, guys. Today we have with us Khyati Sekhar, a second year student at Gujarat National Law University. Khyati is the core committee member of Lighting Dream, and she also represents the editorial board of Lighting Dream. She is a member of GNLU team of international and environmental law, and she has interned under the Tech for India and GNLU Center for Research and Publication. So today Khyati will be discussing the ways for perfect revision and the strategy to unlock success. So the floor is yours, Khyati. You can start.
Thank you, Aryan. Thank you so much for that introduction. Greetings of the day to everyone present here in this meeting. As all of you know, this session is actually for the purpose of guiding you all towards the revision strategies. I hope I will be able to give you some insights in the next 40, 50 minutes, whatever we spend our time together on this session today. Let me just start sharing my screen first. I hope my screen is visible. Is it visible?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. So we'll start with this first one. CLAT 2022. Ready, steady, go. The four things that I have decided that we will be discussing in this session today are things we need to revise, strategy for the revision that we will undertake, and things we need not revise. Okay, things we need not revise, something we do not need to revise, and something that we need to keep for our daily basis. Because at times while preparing, we most often have things that we have to revise, then there are things we do not have to revise. But people don't discuss what about something that you have to keep on a daily basis. You cannot stop revising at any point. That is actually not even revision. You have to do it every day. And all of us know what is that one thing that we have to always do on a daily basis. Everybody knows the most dreaded thing, the general knowledge section, the GK, the current affairs part of GK, and the newspaper, the legal updates you need to be aware about. You have to constantly do it. There is no ending to it. So that is one aspect we will be discussing in the last segment. First of all, I would start with the things we need to revise, and I will then tell you the strategy that, according to me, should help you. Because since I have given CLAT myself and kind of qualified, so I feel like maybe I can tell you guys that what should be the strategy that might help you. Things we do need to revise. First up is general knowledge, the current news that we have from the newspapers. I am sure you all are there on the Lighting Dreams group, so you guys know that we shared Drishti IAS materials. And I would like to bring to your notice that Drishti IAS is one material from which a lot many law competitive exams are bringing in their questions. So that is like a one source that you should always have in your Google Drive, laptop, whatever place you want to keep it. You want to take out a printout, take out a printout. But you should always have it. And that is one section that will always help you in your competitive exams for any legal entrance exam. Since this year I've heard that the paper was not actually a lot of current based, I have added this one section that is rest from varied sources. By this, I actually want to tell you that we have GKs of GK of two types, current news and the history, right? So since I have heard this year, it was a little more on the history part of things, and we are supposed to revise for now CLAT 2022. I am assuming that it is very important for you to take both the certainties in your mind, that there can be a very current based question like I gave in 2020, or maybe a bit history-based question like the one in 2021. In both of these circumstances, at the end of the day, what all we want is you have to qualify the exam. We cannot set the paper. We cannot decide what will be in the paper. So it is very important that you not alone revise from the current section of the newspaper, like whatever notes you make from the newspaper, but it is at the same time very important for you to take into account the varied sources for your history revision, for which I am sure there are materials in the Google Drive of the Lighting Dreams team. But in my opinion, I would also like to suggest something, and that is something I used myself. That book was Manohar Pandey, and I think that's like a very thin book, and it really helps you for the history part of GK. Whatever is like a lot many students do not come from humanities background. They do not know so much. I myself was a PCM student, so I did not really know that well about a lot of things in history. So I think I really relied on that book, and whatever knowledge I had for the GK section in the history segment, it came from that. So one suggestion I have for people is the Manohar Pandey book. Next comes is the quantitative techniques. Let me tell you, these are the things you're supposed to revise, and the revision strategy will be discussed after this. Okay, please just make a note of things you need to revise from here. Okay, there is a message, I'm sure. I need to look at it. What is the message? Is there something on?
It's DI Manohar Pandey 21 or 22.
I would say Manohar Pandey 2022. I am sure you guys are here because you want to do well in the CLAT 2022. So for that, you need to go for Manohar Pandey 2022. Please buy that book. Also, if in case you have Manohar Pandey 2021, I would not stop you from reading it. But before the exam, you should certainly have that book as well. But for the history segment that I'm specifically pointing out, I don't think there are major changes in Manohar Pandey book. So it will not really create a lot of difference for you. If you are only looking for the history segment, because Manohar Pandey book is a very thin book. It also comes with a current affairs section. So I would actually want that you guys have the current affairs section as well, updated section. That is why I would suggest buy Manohar Pandey 2022. And it is already released. I already know it. I'm sure that book is released every year in May only. So I am sure it is released. Buy that one. It is just a 30 rupees investment or a 40 rupees investment. It will be beneficial to everyone. Every section of yours in the GK. Like, it also has legal news as well. So that will also help you. Okay, where were we now? So we were talking here. Things we do need to revise. So general knowledge is dealt with. Next up is quantitative techniques. The things you need to revise in the quantitative technique section are the formulas. I am sure as most of you who come and aspire for CLAT come from humanities background, do have a tendency of not being really good with the math section. But since you have all the time, I would honestly say this, because you have all the time, why not take QT also as an important section and get those 15 marks? I am sure this year also there were rumors of 15 questions came and two of them were cancelled, or three of them were got cancelled, two sets were wrong or something. Some rumors are always around the CLAT exam, I will not deny that. But it is always better to sit in an exam where you are confident about all the sections. It should not be like I'm only good in GK or I'm only good in logical reasoning. If you sit in the exam with the intention that I know all the five sections, I will be able to give my 100% to all those sections, I am sure you will come to this NLU regardless of whether there is a mishap with the paper, with the consortium, or at your center. We need not forget what all has happened with all the batches. Some batches have to, like some people who were revising for 2020, the exam was scheduled in May and they finally gave in September. So a lot of things can happen. At the end of the day, what matters is you need to prepare for yourself. Revision should be so strong that you do not miss out on anything in the paper. If there are 150 questions, do not think that the highest can be 125. So I will get 125. Aim for that 150. That is important. Because when you aim for 150, then you will come to 140. It is not easy to get 150. We all know. But let's aim for the highest we can get, and that is 150. Our competition is not the last year's topper or the last to last year's topper. They are not our competitors. Our competition is those 150 marks. That is the full mark of the exam. We can get those marks if we prepare accordingly for all the sections. And that is what you guys need to do. And for that, I am telling you this revision strategy, which I think will help you to get those 150 marks. Next up is the logical reasoning section. There are some shortcuts to some parts of the logical reasoning. I know there is the whole non-verbal and verbal division in logical reasoning. But in that also, there are some shortcuts available for some part of things. I do not know how much you are aware, how many shortcuts you know, but I am sure there are materials in the Google Drive. And if they are not, don't worry. Before your exam, or before this, I think this is like 13th of August. Before this month ends, I myself will add some shortcut. Like I had some charts, I remember. So I'll put those in the Google Drive. You will have those. And those shortcuts will help you solve a lot many questions. There are questions that you do not really need to put your head into. Like you just need to remember, if the sentence begins with if, then what should be the other part of the sentence? Logical reasoning almost comes with all these sentences. If today it rains, then tomorrow I will go to party. These are some sentences. Now you need to tell what kind of sentence it is or something about it. So these questions can be answered with shortcuts. There are also logical reasoning. Non-verbal comes with all those analytical part of things. So that you have to practice, keep on revising that. And that is the only shortcut. We all know that the non-analytical part, you can revise as many sets you want to, but it is not going to be the end of the world, because in the exam, they can create anything. So it is always important, imperative that you keep on revising these things. Next up is the legal aptitude section. Though its value has actually diminished a lot in the CLAT exam now, but in my opinion, again, you should not leave it completely. You should revise it at least once a month. You may have some 500 questions you revise in 2 days. That's all right. At least once you revise, because in the end of the exam, like one day when you have your examination, be it the 10th of May or the 20th of May, when you sit for the exam, it should not be like, I do not know one section, or I am not inept in a, I am inept in one section. I'm not skilled in one section. All these things will actually take off your confidence, and we do not want that for your next exam. And that exam that is so important for you. This whole time of preparing for that exam is supposed to be utilized well. And I am sure if you look forward, these things will be helpful to you. I have not mentioned one thing here, and I am sorry for that. And that is English. English, I actually recommend, it is very imperative to continue reading English, very boring novels. Very boring novels, or in my opinion, maybe very boring legal update articles from Live Law, Bar and Bunch. Because the most boring it can go is the most good thing for you. Most often, like in 2020, when the pattern changed for the first time, what really happened? Everyone started reading novels, every aspirant. But they started choosing the novels they were reading. So there is a lag with this strategy. What really happens is you get engrossed in the story. You like the story and you are reading it. But the CLAT paper is not going to be a storybook. It is not going to be a novel. You're not going to like it. So how are you going to develop your reading habit? You are reading something you like, so you're reading it. But in the exam, you are supposed to read something you don't like. Then how will your strategy help you? So in that opinion, I would say that you should read something very boring. Read something that you that does not interest you at all. That could be anything. I would say editorials are the first things. Of course, go through the editorials. That is most important. The 4 editorials of Hindu are very good. And then you have, I remember I had 2, the Hindu and Telegraph. Yeah, I think Telegraph also comes up with like 5 or 6. Total, it is 6 and 4 you have in the center. Yeah, so maybe that can also help you. All these are like some things for English, which I have forgotten to mention here. So I hope you guys like understand that all these sections have to be dealt in some way or the other. I cannot actually tell you that this is the final and the soul of all the subjects. But in my opinion, if you do this, you can do better. Things we do not need to revise. It's a big ha-ha here, because there is nothing for the exam that you should not revise, in my opinion, at this stage. This is 13th August 2021. The exam that you are supposed to give is in May. Why should you not revise? Like, why should you leave anything? That is what I was trying to say back then. Because if you start leaving things from right now, you will get this habit, okay, I don't need to study this. This doesn't come in the exam. Legal aptitude was not asked for 2 years. Why will it come now? Non-verbal reasoning is not coming in the CLAT exam. So let's just skip it. Why to do that? You have around 11 months. You clearly know that if you have that much of time, you can do well. Why do you want to waste your time? Simple question. after all, if this exam is so important and getting to an NLU is your dream, then why not invest everything you have? Do your best. That is what I have to say about not revising. Because while I was preparing for this, I asked one of my friends to suggest what should I be doing in this. I think that was Kanish. So Kanish told me that you should talk about what they need to revise, what they do not need to revise. When I actually started thinking about what you should not revise, nothing came to my head. This is August, guys. Come on. You will have your exam in May if things go well. So why do you need to worry about things? Like, why can't you study? Why do you have to think, I will not revise this? This whole time frame is actually for your revision. So please don't waste your time. Please revise. And please don't think that you do not need to revise one part or one section. Vocabulary is not coming in the CLAT exam. So probably not revise vocabulary. Analytical is not coming. Legal aptitude is not being asked. 2 years it has been now. But I would still say that it is of no use to leave it, because it might just not be helpful for CLAT. It can be helpful for some other exam. You can sit for SLAT. You can sit for ALET. You can sit for MHCET, BHU, so much. So I would say also knowledge doesn't go waste ever. Please remember this. So please revise and do everything that you can. Okay, now before moving to the daily section of things, I have to talk about the strategy that you should be following for all this, because that was one thing that I have missed in my slide and I wanted to talk about that. So before I continue talking about it, I would like to speak more on the things. Any doubts, anyone? Yeah, legal reasoning. Okay, I'm sorry, Roshan, I saw your message a bit late. Okay, so I would suggest that for legal reasoning, you should, what I revised was R.S. Agarwal and M.K. Pandey. So you may take those both. Both books are very good. Okay, both of the books are amazing. I finished R.S. Agarwal and I did it twice actually before the exam. M.K. Pandey, I only did once. Also, I did only selected questions in M.K. Pandey, because M.K. Pandey is a bit lengthy book and it is a bit confusing in my opinion. But it has nice explanations. If you understand the explanations, it is good for you. And the book is very trusted. Almost all of the CLAT aspirants do have it. The whole point is, it is not important to have a book, okay? It is important that you solve it. A lot many people will have a lot many sources. We have so many things in our Google Drive, but most of you must have not even seen everything right now. So please look forward to actually visiting the Google Drive and seeing the things you have to, and understanding that this is one time you have to give this exam, and just one time you give it and one time you qualify, you don't have to sit through the whole process again. It will be a good thing and you will have the NLU that you want. That's the best part about winning this exam and winning this whole revision phase. Okay, the strategy, in my opinion, for general knowledge, QT, logic, legal, and English. I will be discussing only whatever I think, okay, guys? I can't actually make it a common thing for everyone. So I will be speaking about what I think is good, and you may follow it. And if you have something to add or suggest, you may please share it in the comment section, or maybe just like unmute yourself and speak. I would be okay with both of it. But please let me complete also. In the general knowledge section, for the current affairs and the history part of things, it is important that you are really updated with the current affairs thing. So if you kind of, this is August, right? So your revision for 2022 would be actually, you will have August, September, October, November, December, January, February, March, April, May is done. Okay, guys. So that is like 10 months from here. And approximately from January, you should be very thorough with everything that you are doing. So before that, you have these 4-5 months in this particular year. And what I would be suggesting for the strategy in general knowledge is, do make notes for your Hindu newspaper or the newspaper you get at your home, because Hindu we share in the group and on the drive. but you can have other things as well. Like you can visit Telegraph, you can have Indian Express. So you can use all that. Make notes for the newspaper. Make only important notes. And what are important? That is a good question anybody can ask here. What are important is something that is current, connected with legal, and not at all political. Yeah, this is what it is. Not at all political, because we are not interested in knowing how many people were killed in any country or any state because of a political reason. Okay, how many people were killed? That is not important. What was the reason? That is important. So it is very important to actually drive yourself away from political and opinionated news. Okay, you should know the facts of something. Like if ISRO has done something or NASA has done something, that is a fact-based question that you may be asked in the paper. Though, of course, it has nothing to do with legal, but it is still a general knowledge important question. But nothing about an MP who was caught in a corruption scandal, that is not really going to be helpful. Probably the corruption scandal, the act or the statute that was used for imprisoning him or taking him into custody, that all might be important and that you should pay attention, not denying that part. But please try to stay away from controversial and political news. Like, don't start getting into Raj Kundra and Shilpa Shetty and their personal lives. Whatever act they have been, whatever their case was, the FIR, whatever statute was used, section, how many days he was there, that is a fact about how many days he has been in the judicial custody. That those are all the facts. So don't try to get into the whole drama about the movie that was released alongside this. All this is crap and the newspaper is not really going to help you that part. That is what you need to find out. So what I suggested, stay away from political, opinionated and controversial news. But always be updated about famous personalities, famous news. There is a difference between controversial and famous. Controversial is something. Controversial is Sushant Singh Rajput's death, okay? And famous is... okay, nobody famous died recently now. Okay, famous. Dilip Kumar died, okay? So that is a famous news. But controversial is how Sushant Singh Rajput died. And nobody is interested. Like, the paper is not interested in questioning you whether it was a suicide or a murder and what do you think, your opinions on it. That is, again, opinionated. Also, the newspapers do not cover it that well. So this is, like, the major difference that you need to find out in the what is important for general knowledge part of things. This you should be revising... you should start revising in January, the current news. Then we have the history segment, and you can probably in history, the history segment of things, you should continue doing it for like 10 days in a month and probably do it every month. 10 days of every month, you should just give to that Manohar Pandey book and you can do it. Or if you can't get the Manohar Pandey book, I'm still sure there are materials available in the Google Drive that cover the GK section of the history, like the GK history segment. QT formulas you will only be able to revise if you actually make a list of those formulas and if you actually solve questions. If you do not solve questions, if you're not interested, it's not going to help you. Remember, if you leave the QT section in the exam, you lose 15 marks straight away. So 150 minus 15, it is for you from the very beginning. So then don't come crying about like somebody has the highest 130 or something. Because man, you already left 15 questions. Please, QT is important. I will always reaffirm this. Logical reasoning, the shortcut sheet, I will be uploading by the end of this week or month. I'm not sure, honestly, but it will be there in August. Okay, I'm sure about that. And you will have that sheet. I am sure most of you must have been confused as to what are the shortcuts in logical reasoning section, but there are some that I know. And I hope you guys are aware. And if most of you are not, then I would be uploading it. You should be revising all the QT or the logical reasoning section probably twice in a week. Now, how does that sound? Twice in a week. That sounds very scary, but it is not scary. The sheet I will be providing and the QT formulas, you just need to revise those. Like, just have a look at them. So you can see them once on Monday and then on Friday, or maybe once on Wednesday and then on Sunday. These things will be helping you throughout. Like, you'd start doing it from January and you have your exam in May. You must have revised at least like January to May, you will probably have like at least 20 weeks. And you must have revised twice in every week. So like 40 times you have revised. Amazing that would be. The legal aptitude section I've already mentioned. You only need to have like 500 questions and revise it only once. Because of course we know that section is not so important. It has not been touched by the new pattern of CLAT since the past 2 years. So it is not important that we cover that section. But I would still say that at least once a month, you can definitely give to that section. That is what I have to say. For English section, I was talking about revising through sectional tests. So for English, you should revise through sectional tests. And if you are, you know that you are good at English or you're not. Okay, everybody, like each one of us know where we stand in a particular section, which is our weaker section. If you think you are good at English, then you should particularly try avoiding revising too much for English, because it is, as it is, the exam will be a 10th based English level. I'm sorry, guys, that was kind of important. Sorry. Next up, I was talking about English. English, I was talking about you need to revise through the sectional test. Then I was talking about if you think it is like your good section, then you should not be investing too much into it. Probably once in 2 weeks. I gave it once in 2 weeks, okay? Because I thought I was good at that section. And the exam already comes at a 10th level English. If you know you are good at a section, why to waste your time into that section? Maybe you can use that somewhere else. You can do something else out of it. I'm not never saying that you can't, okay? You can always take out time for playing games, hanging out with friends. You can definitely do that. I'm not asking you to just sit in your house and study continuously for like 10 hours or 12 hours. One thing good about CLAT examination is you do not need to invest 15 hours of your day. In the beginning, of course. I'm not going to say at the end how much we have devoted. I am sure most of the aspirants who crack it always tell you that at the last time, like the last month or so, they start investing around 15, 16 hours. Yes, we do. We revise extensively and it is very important to do it. Because if you don't, you just start feeling unconfident about yourself. But this is all about the month of March, April, okay? You don't need to worry about it right now. Right now, all you need to do is keep on doing the daily things. Yeah, we will come to the daily things now. The daily things that you need to deal with. Okay, this is not visible. Yeah, here we go. The daily things that are supposed to be dealt with are current news, legal updates, English RC, and QT questions. If you can see, the current news is one thing that will always be coming daily. Like, it is very important every day. 13th August, you have a news. Please revise it on 13th August as well. Make notes in the morning before 12 and revise it before sleeping. You can definitely take out one hour for this. It will not even be 1 hour. 2 hours you take for reading the newspaper and making notes, okay? 1 hour you revise it in the night. And 1 hour I'm talking about people who want to read it slow. People who read fast, they can definitely do it in 30, 45 minutes. It's not too much to ask. Then we have legal updates. Legal updates, you should be doing it from bar and bench and live law. And that would be very good for you because those are the sections. I think the examination department of consortium also brings in the questions. So that is one section from where you can really do well. Next up is English RC. In that section, what we need to do is you can revise through the material that is available in our Google Drive, or at the same time, there are some things that you will be getting from the mocks we will be conducting. So you can revise the English RC section from the mocks and the Google Drive section. those will be sufficient for the RC section. If you feel that you require special attention in English, please put it on the group. We will provide you more materials, please. And we will conduct sessions on it. You know, Lighting Dreams team is really into it, and we would definitely try to help you out with the section. Next is QT questions. In the mocks, I am probably making QT questions for at least one of the sets. So I am sure you guys will have a nice brain session with the QT section. And please solve those questions. Those will be very beneficial. All these four sections you are supposed to do daily. By this, I really implied was revising current news, being updated on live law and bar and bench so that you have the legal updates. Comes up next is English RC. In that section, what you can do is solve at least one section one day. That is not too much to ask. I'm sure most of you have access to the Google Drive. You can find so many RC sections, and then mock examinations. Then you have so much that I would say that even if you start solving one a day, it is not going to get over. In case it gets over, please tell us on the group. We will get you more. Don't worry. It is very important to solve the RC sections, because in the examination, what really it is, you have almost around 15 to 20 passages in the exam. And when you have only 15 to 20 passages in an exam, it gets very monotonous. So you have to actually be experienced to the monotony. And if you do it every day, probably you will be experienced to it. And you will not get half as hard in the exam, or probably not feel bored out of it. So that is one thing very important. And please focus on the RC section. I think if you practice one English RC, your English will also improve. This one is actually for everyone. I'm not even pointing out if you are good at English or not. Please do it every day. And you may start doing it from January, no problem, if you are good at English. But if you are not, then please start doing it today onwards. It is very important. Plus, 10 months to an exam, and English RC should not take more than 10 minutes for you. 10 minutes, you can solve it and actually see what mistakes you are making. So it will be very beneficial. Next is QT questions. If you are not good at QT, okay, the section. So what you're supposed to do right now is take some time. Take August, September, October, November, December. Take these 5 months and like prepare the section. Solve as many things you can. Solve as many formulas you can. Like get all the formulas, solve questions. See demo videos, attend our sessions, see the materials we have on the Google Drive. Get this section on track. Start at least attempting 5 to 6 questions. At least one set you can always attempt. And in a competitive exam, what really happens is, in those 3 sets that we are given in the CLAT exam, 2 of the sets are going to be difficult, but 1 will be easy and it will be solvable. Imagine those 5 marks if you get. If somebody is getting 100, it will be 105. And that would actually be just adding to your score. And you know, 5 marks is like, it will actually put you from DSNLU to an ALSAR. You never know. It is very important. So you should work on that. And in the QT section, what else you can do apart from this is, this is one suggestion I've actually given to all the aspirants I have ever connected. And that is, you should visit this site, cloudaffairs.com. And that site is like very helpful for anybody who really feels they are zero in QT, because I myself was a PCM student, but it was not really that I was so confident about the new pattern DI. So what really happened was this cloudaffairs.com, that section, there you actually find a lot of material for DI-based questions. Cloudaffairs.com is actually a site for banking aspirants, and I think banking also has those similar questions. So that really helps. And this site has questions, tricks to solve those questions, and a list of formulas. So you don't even need to worry about anything. And it also solves those questions. So you have the solutions as well. So this is one site I suggested, cloudaffairs.com. I know most of you might be using it for GK, but if you actually go through the website, you can actually find a section for legal reasoning, logical reasoning, and QT as well. It is very good and will help you with most of your CLAT questions. Moving forward with all these daily things, do you guys think there is any more to answer or anything else you want me to cover? There are some questions. Roshan, I don't really know about GK today. Okay, I did start preparing with GK today, but I don't really think it is quite reliable in my case. I really like Drishti IAS right now. in my preparation time, I relied on Study IQ and the videos that Study IQ uploads. At the same time, I kept myself updated from Live Law, Bar and Bench, the Hindu newspaper. I had some websites on my, like some apps on my phone. They were Jagran Josh. And I still have Jagran Josh on my phone, by the way. It is like very good because you only get like 10 questions in a day and I really love it. I was updated on Cloud Affairs a lot, of like very much. I don't know why, but I was like fascinated with the website and it has really helped me. So I'll try to pass on that whole thing to you guys as well. I hope it helps you all. Okay, I'm gonna stop presenting now because I think it's like done for the day. All the best, guys. All the best for your preparation right now because it might be difficult to sustain yourself till the time it comes to, okay? I know it becomes monotonous and you start really hating yourself and everything is a procedure. But remember, CLAT is an exam that you need to give yourself to, and there is a whole process to finally succeeding in the exam. It is very important to learn from the experience, and this is what is going to happen with you. Good luck. Any more questions? I think I dealt with all the questions.
Thank you, Khyati, for your valuable time. It was just like you left no stone untouched, right? You explained each and every part very well. And again, as usual, this was an amazing session because what happened with the most of the candidate that they feel uncomfortable during their last time to how to revise. But if they continue practice from beginning, it will help them a lot, because from starting the revision is the most important key for anything, because we are not Lord Buddha or something like that. We cannot remember everything. We are normal human persons. So revision is the one of the thing, and it is a very important session, and no one can take better than our core coordinating team member and editorial board team member, Miss Khyati Sekhar. So thank you for amazing session, Khyati, again. Thank you so much.
Thank you.